Hey guys, it's Kathy, and I am here pretty much because I'm bored and I have nothing else to do. And I'm doing talking today. I'm just humor me. I am just here doing my 11 most underrated actors that I have personally heard of. Some you guys might think are more popular than others, but it's okay. I respect that. Sorry, I'm also gonna use my huge ass cell phone. Sorry for the language. I never use language like that. So yeah. So you can see who I'm talking about. And yeah. And if you hear music, it's because I am listening to Eddie and the Cruisers. I like it. I like this. It's the only. I'm in that case, and I'm a movie buff, so why not? And if you guys still think it's a good idea for me to do a Q&A or whatever, please comment below. If you guys also think it's a good idea to do a bookshelf tour or whatever, please let me know. I will do it. Just I gotta get used to the idea that I'm gonna have a bookshelf in my bedroom. So yeah. And if you want to follow me on social media, I will put them in the description box below. So I'm not even gonna bother mentioning them because I am just bored. I'm pretty much being lazy at the moment, so it's okay. The first person I am going to be bringing up is the actor Matt Schultz. You might recognize him from the first Fast and Furious film and the fifth Fast and Furious film. He is underrated. What can I say? I wish he was more. I wish he had more popularity like the rest of the cast of Fast and Furious. Why? Anyway. Yeah. But he's a good actor. He's also in the first two Blade films. What? He is such a good actor. What is wrong with him? I shouldn't say that. What is wrong with these people who do films? Come on. This next celebrity I'm going to be talking about is Carrie Ann Moss. The only reason why I'm talking about her is because she's somewhat starting a TV show she's gonna be starting her own TV show or whatever. And not her own, but she's starring in a new TV show or whatever. And yeah. Sorry, I was messing around my own cell phone. And yeah, the only films that I've really heard her in was the Matrix trilogy back when she was in it, or whatever many Matrix films that there are. Supposedly there's gonna be a new one coming out, but if there is, great. If not, what's the point of watching the Matrix trilogy again? So. The next actor that I'm going to be talking about is Sam Rockwell. He, the only film that I've seen him in is Iron Man 2, with Mickey Rourke as the main bad person, dude. I thought he did a pretty good job. I thought Sam Rockwell did a pretty good job in that film. But that's just me. And if you guys have any more thoughts, great. If not, what's the point of having him on this list if he's also popular like some other people? So, yeah. The next actress I'm going to talk about is Lauren Holly. I can't picture her as an underrated actress at all, because I'm so used to seeing her on NCIS, like the original NCIS. It's like, I'm in shock, because I've actually heard of her. And the next couple of people, some people on this list, I know they're underrated, because I've seen a video having to deal with it, but not all the actors and actresses on the list. Why not? The next actress that I'm going to be talking about is, I can't picture her being underrated, but I think she is. But I could be wrong about that. But it's Dakota Fanning. I think she has an older sister named Elle Fanning, who is in Charlotte's Loving. And yeah. I saw her in Maleficent when she was, I think, a young adult. I don't know the age specifically, but yeah. From now on, I'm probably going to be speechless. Yeah. The next person I'm going to be talking about is Polly Pearl. I can't picture her underrated as... I can't picture her being underrated. Because just like Lauren Holly, I've seen her on the original NCIS. Why? Just why? It's one of those times where it's, are you kidding? Because I've never heard of her being so underrated. Anyway, it's just, the next actor I'm going to be talking about is Steven Lin. You might remember him from the Avatar film, which is the only film that I've personally seen of him. I just can't picture him being underrated at all. So, yeah. I'm out of it. Sorry. The next person I'm going to talk about I've seen in a YouTube video before saying that she was underrated. Yet again, I've seen her in Avatar. I've also seen her in the Star Trek reboot. Her name is Zoe Saldana. And it's just one of those times where we gotta see her in more films. And I don't know what's wrong with people trying to make more actors and actresses underrated. But anyway,
it's not an issue.
Humor me. I'm telling you, humor me. I did research. Anyway, humor me. The last James Marsden. I can't picture him being underrated. Especially if I've seen him in a few of the X-Men films. And who wants to mess with that guy's smile? Who? Huh? Huh? Just who? Yeah. Hollywood's wrong. They should promote their actors. Especially if they're underrated. This is probably the oldest person on the list. But I don't care. It is Kurtwood Smith. You guys might remember him from the original RoboCop film. But in the films that I've seen with him, I saw him in The Christmas Gift with John Denver and all those people. I thought that was a good movie. And you guys might not picture John Denver as an actor, but John Denver is a great actor. And who can see him as an underrated actor? I can't. This actress is known for being Harley Quinn from Suicide Squad. A confusing film. But it's Margot Robbie. Who wants to mess with her? I don't know. But I think she should at least get some more publicity in the film industry. Yeah. Why not? Yeah, why not? This person's kind of last minute, and plus he just got released from prison, and he's more tattoo crazy than he was when he pre-arrested. But it's Cameron Douglas. Yes, I kind of feel like he's underrated. The last film that he did was actually All in the Family back in 03 or 08 or whatever. I personally think he would get, though he retired, I think he should get back in the films and not do drugs. So yeah. I just think he should just get back in the films. See what he's learned from being in jail for as long as he has. And he is the son of Michael Douglas, if you haven't figured that out. as well as the grandson of Kirk Douglas. Yeah. And yeah, I just think we should get back in the films. I've got nothing else other than that, so. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, because I was just bored and I really had nothing to do. When I normally would have something to do, I have this week off. So, yeah. It's just, I'm normally in school, and I normally would be coming home from school around 3:30. I would normally be coming home around 4 or 4:30. So, yeah. Like I said at the beginning of the video, if you think it's a good idea for me to do things like a Q&A or a song quiz or a bookshelf tour when I get a bookshelf and I get everything organized in it, it will, or a sort of film, TV tour, because I'm a huge movie buff, knowing me. Yeah, if you guys think it's a good idea to do those things, just please just comment below. And if you like this video, please press the thumbs up. Comment below if you say how much you enjoyed it too. I'll accept that also. And subscribe to my channel. It'll be a lot of fun. It'll be nice if you guys think it's a good idea for me to do any sort of other challenges, with the exception of the Kylie Jenner challenge or whatever. If you think it's a good idea for me to do certain challenges, just comment below. As long as it's not too messy and I lose teeth or membrane or whatever, just let me, just comment below. And yeah. I don't really care, just let me know. I will help. And I will enjoy the best of my ability. Yes, I'm actually seeing the movie. I love movies. Thank God I got that. Yeah, I like movies. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Sorry for the short notice. I know on Tuesday I didn't say I didn't feel like doing it, but I just felt like I needed to do it, so. Yeah. I need something to do. So, yeah. Thanks for watching the video. Bye.